Hi, welcome to another Digital Anarchy tutorial. I'm Jim Tierney, and we're going to be talking about our great new plugin for doing skin retouching in Photoshop, Beautybox Photo. We'll discuss a little bit about what it is, how it works, and how you can get the most out of it. So let's dive into it. We'll start off by going to the Filter menu, go to Digital Anarchy, and select Beautybox. This will bring up the Beautybox UI, and we'll go ahead and zoom in on our extremely excited model. She's extremely excited to have her skin retouched, as most models are. And so you can see by default, Beautybox automatically applies some skin smoothing. And we can take a look at the before and after by clicking on Command or Control G. And I'll show you the original and the Beautybox version, and you can switch back and forth between the two. You can also right-click on the preview window, and it'll show you all of this information as well, all the different keyboard shortcuts, including Show Original. So we'll get back to our Beautybox version. Now, Beautybox is doing some cool stuff here. We're running face detection to figure out where the skin tones are and how large the person's face is, so we can kind of figure out what automatic settings to apply to this. And so that's how the smoothing controls are determined. We then use the skin tones to build an automatic mask. And if you want to take a look at that mask, you can click on Show Mask, and it'll render it for you. And you can see we've created an excellent mask on her face of the skin tones, where white is Beautybox fully applied, black is no application, and the shades of gray are partially applied. And you can see that the only shades of gray we have here are in the darker areas of her face. And the lighter shades are almost fully applied. But there tends to be less detail in the darker areas, so I'm not too worried about this. Overall, it's a really nice mask, so I'm pretty happy with it. So I can click Show Mask Off, and it'll take us back to our original image. And now we can go up and start tweaking the smoothing controls. So by default and by design, Beautybox is a little bit subtle when you first apply it. We're not trying to sandblast the person in the photo. One of the goals with Beautybox is really to keep things looking realistic and just really applying a kind of a layer of digital makeup. So in some cases, there might not be quite enough smoothing, or you might want to tweak the settings and go for a little bit different look than what Beautybox has by default. And so to do that, the main way is to go up to the smoothing controls. And we can start making adjustments. Let's set this to, say, 26, and we'll keep skin detail where it's at. And now if I go back and forth between the original and the Beautybox version, you can see there's a little bit more smoothing going on. It's a little bit more pronounced. We're doing a great job of keeping the skin kind of like nice and smooth and almost buttery, and also dealing with all the blemishes and skin damage down along her chin. And again, you don't want to get rid of every last wrinkle. You still want the person to look human. That's always generally a good thing. So you're going to still see some fine lines around her eyes. You know, the wrinkles on her forehead, obviously, we want to keep. That's pretty important. So again, it's really just about applying a layer of digital makeup. And smoothing amount is really kind of the master control here. It's what's setting the overall amount of smoothing. The smoothing radius is basically how large of an area the smoothing amount samples. So if you have somebody with blotchy skin, you really want to have this set to a higher number, and we'll create more of a smoother gradient over the entire face. If the subject doesn't have very blotchy skin, then a smoothing radius of a 10 or 15 is usually fine. And the skin detail amount just allows you to kind of dial up or dial down the amount of skin texture the person has. So in a lot of cases, we want to keep things like pore structures, the fine lines, and the higher you crank up skin detail, the more of that you're going to keep. Although if you crank this up too far, it's going to really increase your render times. So 30 is usually a pretty good balance of keeping some skin texture and keeping the render times very fast. Now you can also use the preserve small detail down here, and that will also help you keep skin texture. And so now let's talk about the image controls. You may have noticed, as I've been kind of going back and forth, the Beautybox does a really excellent job of keeping other details in the image razor sharp. So if you look at the eyelashes, the jewelry, the teeth, the hair, all of that remains really sharp while the skin gets smoothed out. And a large part of that is due to preserve edges. So preserve edges is really great at identifying the details in the image that are not skin and need sharpening. And so the really good range is usually between 50 and 100. In some cases, especially if the subject has really deep wrinkles, you may want to set this down to around 50 because you don't want to sharpen the wrinkles too much. But overall, it does an amazing job of just really keeping the sharpness to those details, you know, especially the ones that cross over the skin, like the eyelashes here and the jewelry. And there's also additional sharpening built in. The sharpening amount basically does a sharpening pass on the entire image, kind of a light sharpening, again, just to make sure those important details are kept sharp while we're just smoothing out the skin. And you can crank this up if you want, but usually you just want to have a touch of sharpening applied to the entire image, and that really helps make things pop out that should be. Now, as you may have noticed, there are basic color correction controls in here. So if you just want to warm the skin up a little bit or add a little bit of brightening, you can do that right here within BeautyBox. Now, if you're going to do hardcore color correction, if the image really needs a lot of color correction work, I'd probably recommend doing that in Photoshop before you come into BeautyBox. But, you know, again, if you just want to just warm the skin up a little bit, the color correction controls right here are a great way of doing that. And, of course, we have presets in here. So if you want to save some settings that you've used on one image and apply it to other ones. Now, this is a great place to point out that BeautyBox is fully Action and Bash compatible. That's really the point of it. So you can certainly use BeautyBox as part of an action and then use that to batch process, you know, a folder full of 100 images or whatever. And so it's a really powerful way of doing basic skin retouching on a large number of images. As I mentioned, BeautyBox automatically uses face detection to figure out what the smoothing controls should be and what the mask should look like. So you really can automatically apply this to a large number of portraits without you having to go in there and manually do stuff. Now, in some images, the mask may not be quite as good as you'd like. So we can go into our Show Mask mode, and we can grab the Add Skin Color control, and we can just click on the gray areas. And what this does is it's not sampling the black or white here. It's really sampling the underlying skin tones, and it's expanding the skin tone range that's making this mask. So we can click on her nose as well and include that area. And in this case, I don't think it makes too much of a difference. I think the mask was really good to begin with. But this improves it even further. And you will run into images that, you know, especially have high contrast, there's, you know, a shadow falling across the face, where the mask will pick up some tones and really not pick up the other tones. And the Add Skin Color is a really good way of improving that mask and include all the skin tones around the subject of the photo. Now, one other powerful workflow tool that I haven't really talked about is the snapshots. This allows you to compare settings. So, for example, if I want to compare these settings to, say, our original settings, I can click on my snapshot. I'll click Save. And what this is going to do is save all of the parameters that I have listed here. And so if I make some adjustments, say if I really want to crank this up, go for something that's a little bit on the ridiculous side, that's going to apply way too much smoothing. But now I can take a look at this compared to my other settings. So with the number one selected, I can click on View. And this will take me back to the save settings. And of course, I can click that on and off and see the current settings and the save settings. Current, saved, etc. And we can even click on Command G to look at my original. So that's the original. That's the save settings, and that's the current settings. And if you decide you like the save settings better, then you can just click on the load button, and that will load all those settings right back in there, and you're good to go. So it's a really fast and easy way of comparing different settings, because in a lot of cases, the changes are going to be kind of subtle, especially with smoothing radius, and just switching the controls back and forth is really not very helpful. But being able to save the snapshots out, being able to view one, two, or three, or the original, It's a really nice way of working and speeding the whole process up. So that's the basics of BeautyBox. As you can see, it's a very fast and easy way of doing this type of retouching, especially if you're using it through a batch process. Again, thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next tutorials.